Und es geht weiter mit Les Perfectmentora und Shimoda. Wir sind immer noch auf dem Weg zum Onryo Castle. Dort wartet natürlich hier Amakasa auf uns, der hier immer noch seine satanistischen Rituale aufführt. Wir müssen diesen immer noch bezwingen und beim letzten Mal haben wir hier erstmal unsere Kinder abgeladen und Dante getroffen, der natürlich ganz sicher nicht der Dante ist, den wir kennen. Und mögen wir schon echt den Typen. Naja. Wir schwingen uns zumindest jetzt weiter hier zum Mario Castle und hoffen einfach mal, dass wir hier, ja, mal weiterkommen. Ich denke mal, ja, das sollte akzeptable Party sein. Bin unsicher, aber, soll schon schaffbar sein. Soll schaffbar sein. Ich hoffe es. Wenn nicht, dann habe ich Pech gehabt. Dann müssen die Befehlsserver müssen da rein. Okay, liebe Leute, dann würde ich sagen, legen wir los und dann machen wir die Blatt. Das ist the same castle we were at before, right? Look at how much it changed. If there was ever a castle made just for monsters, then this would be it. Dante was right about this place. I can't even imagine how much evil stuff you'd have to mix together to get something like this. I can see why that missionary guy had a lot to say about it. No wonder there's no one else around. Do you hear that, Maxi? Is it just me or does it sound like the castle has a heartbeat? It's not just you, it's a living creature. Jeez, they're not even trying to settle, are they? And here I was wondering where an enemy has hidden their base of operation. Yeah, this is not ganz so schwer unbedingt zu übersehen. I guess they deserve some credit. Since we didn't find the hideout before this happened. Now they've got us on the defensive. But that all ends tonight. Are you guys ready for this? Of course. I won't back down now. Not after having come this far. I may not be fully recovered. The master won't, may not have healed. But as long as we're all together, I can't imagine us losing. Let's go. It's time to settle this once and for all. There could be a gauntlet or a battle royale. True, and we don't know which it'll end up being. But the important thing is that we are ready for anything. Now we just need to figure out how to get inside this creepy looking castle. Heat source is detected. A large number of monsters are materializing inside the castle grounds and walls. Preparing for combat now. Come monsters. Looks like an opening egg, a pack of monsters, and a man-eating monstrosity. No more grumbling. Let's cut our way through these things and make our way inside. So, okay. Natürlich wird es nicht so leicht, hier reinzukommen. Die Frage ist natürlich, wo auch unsere Prinzessin Kyuhyun ist. Und natürlich auch, was dann so hier in dem Part macht. Wir haben ja, also in dem Kapitel hier, wir haben ja am Anfang so wieder ein Flashback gesehen, dass sie hier sich dem Caster of Limbo hier verpflichtet fühlt. Ich muss immer noch sagen, ich hätte es immer noch sehr viel cooler gefunden, wenn man nicht wüsste, dass sie für ihn arbeitet. Weil ich meine, jetzt wäre es natürlich klar gewesen mit der einen Szene, aber ich hätte es so cool gefunden, wenn man das wirklich am Anfang gar nicht gewusst hätte, dass sie ein Teil der Organisation ist. Weil das hat, finde ich, viel spannender gemacht. Aber okay. Okay, Leute. Die McAllie ist nun in der Hood. Ich bin mir noch nicht sicher, ob Spartacus es schafft, die zu bezwingen. So. Ah, genau, passt. Okay. Naja, ich habe mir extra den Command-Coacher ausgerüstet, weil ich dachte mir schon, dass da. Ich habe vergessen, ob ihr MP 10 oder 20 oder 30 MP gibt. Aber es sind nur 10. Wenn ihr mir einen Gefallen tut, bitte besiegt die. Weil die könnten meine Mecha-Eddies uns sehr, sehr wehtun. Aber ich glaube, Spartacus macht nur 36.000. Ah, Türschnitt. Was soll ich? Nein! Wäre ich nicht so geizig gewesen. Ein Spartacus-Buster kacken. Wenn du jetzt eine Welt machst, spucke die an. So. Weil es aber so schön. Ah, oh, Leute, komm. Jetzt kommen die Mech-Elikarten. Komm. Fatal Battle. Banefuloni, okay. Oh, schau dich das an, schau dir diese Mech-Elikarten an. Oh. So. Nur die Offensive wählen wir. Nur die Offensive. Was habe ich denn eigentlich mit der? Ich glaube. Oh, ich habe. Habe ich da. Nein, ich habe Barrel Drive ausgerüstet. Ich dachte gerade, der bespurte Sattler. Ich hoffe nicht. Ich will ja Damage raus haben, Mann. Start the fair. Send nix aber. Die haut so rein, Mann. Die haut so rein, Mann. So, Leute. Langt nicht für den Clean Kill, aber voll in Ordnung, Mann. Guter Schaden. Oh, Spartakus ist unsterblich, oder wie, Mann? Okay, Leute, aber ihr habt keine Chance, denn ich aktiviere nun seine Geheimwaffe. Und ich hoffe, das langt. Mega Ellis Karte soll schön critten. Oh ja, locker. So, best Mecha Ellie, liebe Leute. Fight me, Mann. Eigentlich auch best Ellie, weil ich meine, alle anderen Endies sind schlecht, Mann. Weil sie Ellie sind. Aber ich mag sie, liebe Leute. Deswegen habe ich sie ja meistens hier dabei. Okay, liebe Leute. Erste Welle hier an Feinden zurückgeschlagen. War wahrscheinlich aber noch nicht alles. Und wir rücken weiter vor. Ich sage, es wird langsam richtig spannend. Mir gefällt auch das Design von dem Schloss. Hast es eliminated. We now have the clear path forward into the castle. This way, my enhanced vision confirms that this castle interior is identical to Tokyo Castle. We shall take the shortest path available to keep. Please, hurry. You. Okay, let's get going. After all our waking and horseback riding, this last leg of our journey. That sure is hard to keep, isn't it? This last leg could be especially hard for my old man like me. I carry myself if I have to. Don't be ridiculous. I'm the only one who'll be carrying you if you get tuckered out. I may be old, but I'm still in my prime. Alright, Duran. In we go.
Der war schön, Mann. Der war schön. So, war vielleicht der beste Satz, den jemals unser Hauptcharakter abgelassen hat.
Okay, Ladies and Gentlemen, die nächste Runde kommt. Wir wählen. Ja, wen wählen wir denn? Brauchen wir einen Support? Na. Nur Musashi mit. Ihr seht übrigens schon, Danzo ist nicht mehr dabei. Und dann werden wir das mit der Party schon schaffen. Ja. Yeah. Danzo mit ihrer 80% der Pi-Batterie. Das ist so nice, Mann. Nur mal so als kleine Randnotiz. Okay, next round. Und das, oh, das war der vorher schon mal kämpfen.
Well, at least this place looks familiar. I think this is where we first met with Kyuhime, inside the castle and where we fought Paraiso.
I believe it is. It may look a lot creepier than it did back when, then, but the castle's layout appear identical. Asasha seems safe to assume this is the same area. That aside, I wonder why we haven't run into anyone yet. It works out well for us in that neither I have to fight, nor rescue anyone, but I can't help but find it's unsettling.
Much as I'd like to think it's because I ran in the castle and managed to escape. I doubt they were that lucky.
Und dieses Bumpern wird lauter.
Just to listen to the heartbeat. If you told me this castle suddenly grew a mouth and ate up everything inside it, I believe you. And this is clear, no place for humans.
Let's hurry and find Kyuhime.
I agree. Still, it's strange. I figured we'd run into more monsters in here. It's almost like they weren't expecting any intruders.
Beats me. Now come on, let's kick on. Tell us where we need to go next, guard.
Lady Danzo? I have something I need to tell you.
Hmm? Is it about the castle?
No. No, it's about the castle. Not about the castle or our route. But if I miss this chance, I may never be able to say this. As such, I believe it would be best to do so now. When there are no monsters around. Although, when it comes to making decisions, my ability to judge matters correctly is severely diminished right now.
I said how it feels to you, Danzo. I certainly don't get the depression. Oh my god, wir müssen gegen sie kämpfen. You are
helping us out after all. I don't think you need to say something you're not comfortable with. But
you just can't let this go, huh?
In that case, let me guess what is want to say. You've actually been on the Sosso side all along, am I right?
But how? I never mentioned anything of the sort. In fact, I'm certain I never gave away any information about my circumstances or loyalties.
Es war die Beziehung zu Fuma, oder?
How did you? No, should I ask. When did you first suspect me?
Pretty much from the start. I think it was less that I had an actual suspicion than just a feeling.
Is that true for all of you? Even you, Lord Kataru?
Well, I didn't catch on as quickly as Lady Musashi did, but we ninja trained to always be vigilant of others and their motives. After you fought Paraiso, my suspicion that you were hiding something were confirmed.
And since there's only one thing a ninja could do hiding, that confirmed you were working for our enemy.
Yeah, why do you think I invited you into my hermitage? I'd rather have you gathering intel where I could see you than sneaking around behind my back.
Did you know too, Lord Maxi?
I realized after the children were adopted. Oh yeah, good point. Danza was seriously flustered when that happened, wasn't he?
Weil sie komplett auch nicht damit gerechnet hat.
So you knew about me all along, Lady Musashi. Then Lord Kotaro figured it out soon after, as did Lord Maxi. And Lord Muramasa saw from me right from the start. Then, why? Why didn't you kill me? With your skills, you could have done so easily.
Why would I do that? Everyone's got their own troubles to deal with, and it's not like you attacked us. Whatever your job might be, you still risk your life to help us. That's more than enough for me to trust you.
Exactly. Even if you had been secretly planning an attempt on Master's life, I was prepared to keep him safe. I have both the ability and the confidence to pull that off. If I didn't, I could never have let any enemy ninja accompany us. Besides, this sort of things happens all the time during the Age of War, Lady Danzo.
Also, I couldn't help but notice yet you started to wrestle with something along the way. I can't speak for everyone else, but personally, I wanted to wait and see what the answer you arrived at.
Why?
Because you're beautiful, of course. Kidding. I was just trying to lighten the mood.
Danzo Musashi confirmed.
What I meant was, you're not a bad girl at heart. Oh, right. You're older than me, so not a bad woman at heart. Anyway, that's what I thought. And it looks like I was right. After all, the reason you decided to speak up now is because you felt you could wait any longer to say something, isn't it?
I'm glad I was right about you, Lady Koto Danzo. As a ninja, I cannot fail my mission. Thus I was planning to kill all of you. All the Lord Empire taught me to assist you when you fought against that heroic spit sword masters. Lord Limbo also taught me to kill you if the chance presented itself. But back then, when Lady Samgata held Lady Katsurete, held abducted Oni and Lord Tazuke, I was surprised to find myself feeling a great pain waiting on my chest. From then on, I was no longer sure what I should do.
What? You think the kids were abducted because you did something to my barrier? Don't be an idiot. I'm a servant. There's no way any flesh and blood ninja could get through it. You didn't do anything to my barrier. It just wasn't good enough to keep those two Oni out. Besides, I don't have any great military strategy. I'm just a swordsmith. If I had to do it all over again, I would.
Huh? So, you do not blame me for placing your grandchildren in danger?
Why would I? That wasn't your fault. If I blame anyone, I blame Musashi and Maxi. All they did was eat my food and use my hermitage as a hideout. Lord Muramasa!
So, everyone, one of you knew all along, and you were still kind enough to keep me by your side. I never would have guessed it. I was the only one who didn't realize that what was going on. I'm well and truly broken. Or perhaps it's more accurate to say, I was never fixed. I'm a machine whose only purpose is to carry out its master's orders. In that sense, I'm no different from a sword, or a spear, or a matchlock, or a wheel. I am a tool, a finger whose only purpose is to be used by another. Lord Kotaro.
Yes?
According to my records, you taught Paraiso that a ninja without a soul is nothing more than a hollow blade. I agree with that completely. And that's what I try to be. But I couldn't. As I am now, I'm neither proper ninja nor hollow blade. At some point, I gained a soul. And so, there's something I wish to tell you. Please, believe me when I tell you that I am here now of my own accord. I feel I led you to undo the castle of my own volition, and I hope that you will prevent this its activation.
You mean this still isn't its final form?
Die Musik.
No, that missionary we ran into was correct. Once Lady Kyurem is sacrificed, and this castle takes a soul. And the castle will activate its curse, and fully take root here in the world Shimosa. We must stop the sorcerer before that happens, or the darkness will destroy this and many other peaceful worlds. And then flow into your smell up, Maxi. So then, this whole abnormality can actually cross into different worlds.
Limbo. What a joke! Your own volition? A motive to rebel? Did you really think a broken down puppet like yourself would be permitted such things? How absurd. Free will, unautomating, become conscious? How utterly absurd, laughable, even. Never in all my life have I heard anything so preposterous. Admittedly, I'm enjoying watching you squirm and agonize all over this. At the very least, it serves to all to my bottom.
That voice.
Cast off, Limbo! Damn it! I thought you would still be a drift sorcerer. Please be careful, Aaron. His sorcery is tremendously powerful. If it hits you directly, not even you will escape unscathed.
Even after you betray us, this is the best advice you can offer them? What an utter joke. I must make sure to do a better job preparing you next time. Or perhaps I should have broken you more thoroughly. Up until now, I was only breaking you a bit at a time. Simply because it was comical to see you flailing about in a state of disrepair. Maybe I should have fixed you properly after all. Yes, that's it. Next time, I'll crush about 70% of your brain.
What? What did you say?
I did say that I broke you. What about it? When I found you, your limbs and exterior were severely damaged. I suppose you had shut down due to a lack of magical energy. So I broke you. I mixed up with your mental records, turning you into a broken down puppet. Oh, but I did fix your damaged body, of course. I do hope you appreciate that.
I don't like your voice. You're the kind of wields words like weapons, using them to better your opponents. I'm the kind of person who will do anything to win too, but there are three things I just won't abide. First, one-sided slaughter, the killing of unarmed people. Second, tying with other people's pride and beliefs for our own amusement. Third, stealing food from someone who's hungry. And you're already 2 out of 3. Let me guess, you're sticking to the shadow because you're just too damn ugly, right? Stop hiding, you deviant! Show yourself!
Oh my god, man! Very well, I shall comply with your request, Lady Shimemuzashi. I believe this is the second time we have met in person, yes? I believe the last time back in the Bamboo Forest, how good of you to come all this way to your own Ryudo Castle.
Oh, he's actually really handsome. I mean, he's not type or anything, but wow.
Musashi! Musashi! Hallo, aufwachen!
Huh? Don't worry, I'm fine. That's just a reflex. Anyway, just pretend it didn't happen. So you finally shown yourself, Volan. Your voice may be ugly, but I admit the rest isn't bad. You do strike me as a beautiful predator type, huh?
An accurate appraisal, thank you. Now that we have properly met, I would ask that you call me. Abe no Semi.
The Emperor's legendary Umjuji? Semjo, you're a Semi? You've got to be kidding me!
A better name, I think. He's supposed to be a fairly well-known in the caster community.
Abe no Semi, Garden of Kyoto, and a genius among the Umuji. He was a legend, the highest rank of astrologers and the master of yin and yang techniques. It said be even a new secret spell that could bring the dead back to life. It also said that a man, a true name defeated with white-faced nine-tailed fox, one of the great monsters that threaten of Japan.
Oh, Kitsune, tamamo no me.
Some stories say he was superhuman born to a fox, who went on to live an exceptionally long life. It makes sense that a person like that would leave his mark on humanity as a rogue spirit, but...
You shouldn't look like a guardian of anything to me. If anything, I'd have to say... You have the face of an irredeemable villain.
You've got me there.
Haha, it's nice to see if you got a sense of humor. In that case, maybe we could find a way to resolve this without...
A barrier? Indeed!
Lady Musashi, look out! I see you went after Lady Musashi from behind Lady Danzo. I didn't mean... Oh no, I can't stop! I can't stop myself, look, Kotaro! I'm so sorry, it seems that I was actually playing into the cast of Limbo's hands all along. I thought that I had brought you here off my own accord in order to stop the sorcerer. I really believed that I was acting on my own free will. That is truly how it felt to me. But in fact, it seems I was nothing more than a foolish puppet. Look, Kotaro, Eren, I must kill you now.
I believe you, Lady Danzo, and I thought that something like that might happen.
Wonderful! I'm so glad you turned out to be a kind-hearted source willing to play along with my little farce. Then come and dance with my puppet. Of course I doubt a broken down doll will be enough to satisfy you. So I've also prepared a small group of monsters to go with her. Also allow me to explain why you have yet to come across any monsters within this castle so far. I've been holding them back for the very moment, so I could witness your death for myself. Since the world is coming to an end, anyway, you may as well put on a good show for me. Demon heretic.
Danzo.
Goodbye, love Maxie. One way or another, this is where we part ways.
Oh yes, Danzo, stronger than you might think. So be careful. Now to drop your gun. You see, I've imputed here with a special form of my sorcery. One that recreates the curse of annihilation's karma from machinery. It is one of my greatest techniques, as silly capable of destroying even a servant. I do hope you enjoy it, Master of Chaldea, Shime Musashi.
Der Cast of Limbo, Seven. Von all den Servants, die ich bis dato getroffen habe, in doch meiner schon einigen Feldgeschichte. Es gibt keinen, der so eine Präsenz, so einen Wahnsinn und so eine komplette Bosheit ausstrahlt, wie der Cast of Limbo. Zudem glaube ich, ich nicht unbedingt spoilern muss, dass wir diesen nochmal treffen werden in der Fate-Welt. Und auch sein nächster Auftritt wird wahrscheinlich spektakulär grausig. Wieso darf der eigentlich anfangen? Ne, nur damit er mich cursen kann. Eh, klar. So, wie hoch ist die Chance, dass ich Wavers MP voll bekomme? Gering. Ah, jetzt 70%? 30% muss ich jetzt mit ihm holen. Dann muss ich jetzt 3 Arztkarten ziehen. Leute! Wir haben seine MP. Jetzt muss er 7% noch hinbekommen. Passt einmal frei. Und jetzt ist Destroying Time, meine guten Freunde. Es tut mir leid, Danzo. Also mir tut sie gerade echt leid, Mann. Mir tut sie gerade richtig, richtig leid, Mann. Kato Danzo. Gezwungen vom Cast of Limbo. Greift sie uns hier an. Und auch wenn sie es nicht will, muss sie hier kämpfen, Mann. Ich sag ja, sie tut mir richtig, richtig leid, Mann. Sie hat hier... Sie war hier so fest der Einstellung, Mann. Sie hat ihre Dämonen bezwungen und kämpft hier in Wahrheit für uns. Hat sich über ihren Schatten... Ist über ihren Schatten gesprungen. Doch in Wahrheit war sie nur in der Leine von einem Monster, was grausamer ist als alles, was wir im Endeffekt bis jetzt getroffen haben. Es ist wirklich, es ist echt so schlimm, Mann. Er ist so furchtbar, Mann. Er ist so grausig, Mann. Und mir tut dann sogar echt leid, Mann. Die ist mir gerade so derb ins Herz gewachsen. Da so muss ich sie platt machen. Und jetzt kommt leider das kleine Magical Girl. Und das wird schmerzhaft werden. Und besonders für Fumo, Mann. Fumo, der wirklich sie so anlächelt und sagt, hey, okay. Er hat ja gesagt, sie ist seine Mutter, Mann. Boah, Alter, damit ist das Krass, Mann. Aber wie gesagt, das macht das im Endeffekt nur noch schlimmer. So, das Stun hat gewirkt. Jo, keine Ahnung, was wir jetzt machen. Hat ehrlich gesagt gehofft, dass das langt. Zack. Ihr könnt euch ein bisschen quitten. Okay, kein Problem. Bitte mach keine. Keine Evades, bitte. So, warte mal. Ich weiß nicht, ich habe das Gefühl, ihre Buster-Karten hauen mehr rein. Ich glaube, sie hat keine MP-Batterie. Das heißt, sie kann uns jetzt nicht so gefährlich werden. Komm, Crit! Ja, sehr schön. Crit nochmal! Oh, die Crits, Mann. Ja, jetzt macht sie es invincible, okay. Aber das stört uns jetzt weniger. Weil wir das hier machen. Mit dem Damage Card sollten ihre Face-Karten nicht allzu viel Schaden machen. Ich habe keine Ahnung, ob das... Das Blöde an ihren Skills ist wirklich, als Gegner ist das eigentlich ganz fies, Mann, weil sie kann ihre Skills im Endeffekt einsetzen, wie sie will. Und sie könnte jeder nur einen Evade, einen Invincible machen. Jetzt leider ein letztes Mal sehen wir NLP. Mir ist gerade aufgefallen, dass ihr MP AOEs, Mann. Das ist mir gerade aufgefallen, Mann. Ich habe sie doch vorher schon eigentlich benutzt, Mann. Ich war mir gerade irgendwie, ich war gerade der festen Anstellung, dass ihr MP Single Target ist, Mann. Aber okay. Dann überlasse ich es dir, Shimen Musashi. So. Aber ich glaube, schafft sie echt gut nicht. Ah, doch. Okay. Ja. Und nun haben wir leider der Puppe ihren Chaos gemacht. Ach, das ist scheiße. Aber Leute, Mann. Egal wie schlimm es ist, ihr dürft nicht vergessen, der Mann, der hinter diesen vielen furchtbaren Sachen stand. Und ich rede jetzt hier nicht von Amakazu, ich rede von dem Cast of Limbo. Er steht endlich in Reichweite. So fast. No, you're just as long, my Lady Musashi. Damn, she's keeping pace with Musashi. Guess Sammy wasn't bluffing about the common nonsense. Before I go, let me say thank you. Thank you for treating me, this foolish puppet, like a real person. And forgive me. Lady Musashi. Danzo! Farewell. That sound. She just activated something inside herself. Lady Musashi, get back! Musashi, your eye. I'm okay. Never mind me. Danzos. Kota. Lakotaro. Lakotaro. I cannot see. Where are you? I must have gotten separated from them. All of you, please. Hurry and stop the sorcerer. It's my fault those two children endured such a nightmare. I have to make amends. Oh, that's right. Lakotaro. I have met you. Somewhere before, haven't I? Mara!
Das war mir jetzt echt zu schlimm, Mann. Das war mir jetzt echt zu schlimm, die Szene, Mann. Das war jetzt... Das war jetzt echt schlimme Szene. Musashi verliert ihr Auge. Und Danzo erinnert sich endlich an Fuma in ihrem letzten Ding. Sprengt sich selbst in die Luft. Cast of Limbo. Du wirst dafür bezahlen und wie bitte. Beim nächsten Mal werden wir dir sowas von in den Allerwertesten retten, du Clown-Monster. Beim nächsten Mal geht's richtig los und dann geht's weiter mit Fake Grand Order. Bis dahin, haut rein, auf Wiedersehen, ciao.